Hello everyone, my name is Joseph and I am part of the Identity Experience Cloud Engineering team at Microsoft. In this video, I'm going to explain what the new Azure AD Authentication method policy is and how it works together with the legacy MFA and SSPR policies. Also, I'm going to show how you can migrate from SMS and phone authentication methods to the Microsoft Authenticator method. To start, let's understand what authentication methods are. Azure Active Directory allows the use of multiple authentication methods to support a wide variety of signing scenarios. Administrators can specially configure each method to meet their goal for user experience and security. Some of the authentication methods are Authenticator app push notifications or phone sign-in, software tokens OTP, FIDO2 security keys, hardware tokens OTP, among others that I will continue showing during the video. What is the new Azure AD Authentication methods policy? The new authentication methods policy is a recommended way to manage Azure AD authentication methods. These methods can typically be used anywhere in Azure AD for both authentication and password reset scenarios. The exception is that some methods are limited to using authentication, such as FIDO2 and Windows Low for Business, and others are limited to using password reset, such as security questions. It is important to mention that only the core registration experience is aware of the authentication methods policy. Users in the scope for this policy, but not for the Convert Registration experience, won't see the correct methods to register. What are the legacy MFA and SSPR policies? These two policies, located in multi-factor authentication settings and password reset settings, provide a legacy way to manage some authentication methods for all users in the tenant. As you can see from the screen, from these policies you can also disable and enable the methods that you want the users to register and use. Now, let's understand how all of these policies work together. Settings are not synchronized between the policies, which allows administrators to manage each policy apart. Azure AD respects the settings in all of the policies, so a user who is enabled for an authentication method in any policy can register and use that method. To prevent users from using the method, it must be disabled in all policies. The registration process checks first authentication method policy, second legacy MFA policy, and third, the legacy SSPR policy. Let's walk through an example where a user who belongs to the accounting group wants to register for the Microsoft Authenticator method. The registration process first checks authentication method policies. If the accounting group is enabled for Microsoft Authenticator method, the user can register for it. If not, the registration process checks the legacy MFA policy. In that policy, any user can register Microsoft Authenticator if one of these settings is enabled for MFA. Notification through mobile app, verification code from mobile app or hardware token. If the user cannot register Microsoft Authenticator based on either of those policies, the registration process checks the legacy SSPR policy. In that policy too, a user can register Microsoft Authenticator if the user is enabled for SSPR on any of these settings: mobile app notification, mobile app code. Now that we understand the difference between policies and portals, I will show you a demo on the steps that you can take as an admin to enable Microsoft Authenticator as a default method. As you can see from my legacy MFA portal, I only have call and SMS enabled. From the authentication methods policy blade, we can see that Microsoft Authenticator is also disabled. From my SSPR policy blade, I have disabled SSPR over my tenant. This means that the user will only be able to register for call or SMS method. In order to enable Microsoft Authenticator method, let's go back to the authentication methods policy. Let's click on Microsoft Authenticator, and now let's just enable the policy for all my tenant. Once the policy is enabled, let's go to the registration campaign feature. Let's click on Edit and enable it. Once it is enabled, it will start prompting up for the users the option to configure the Microsoft Authenticator app each time that the user signs into the portal. The notification can be skipped, but as an admin, we can configure here how many days the user is permitted to skip the configuration before it is forced to register. Now that we configured the policies in the portal, let's see how it looks from the end user experience. I will authenticate with this user. It is requesting my current MFA method. Once it is completed, you can see it is asking if I want to configure the Microsoft Authenticator app or if I want to skip it for now. For this demo, I will proceed to configure it now. Now, let's configure the account. Open the Authenticator app on your mobile phone. Click on Add Account. Then scan the QR code in your screen. This will automatically add the account to the Microsoft Authenticator app. Once this is done, please complete the authentication request. After the authentication request is successfully completed, you will see the Microsoft Authenticator app going as a default sign-in method for your user. Now that we have completed the registration for the Microsoft Authenticator app, you can see that it is showing up the phone authentication and the Microsoft Authenticator method. In this scenario, the Microsoft Authenticator method will be used as a default sign-in method. This is how, as an administrator, you can configure authentication method policies and enable the registration campaign for the Microsoft Authenticator app. Hopefully, you will find this video helpful. For more information, please refer to our public documentation at learn.microsoft.com. Thank you for your time, and see you next time.